Morning students, welcome back. Today we'll discuss numerical based on resistance and capacitance. So let's start. Okay, look student, first of all I'm going to explain the circuit diagram. We are given a circuit in which 3 microfarad, 3 microfarad, okay, 1 microfarad, 1 microfarad and 1 microfarad capacitor are connected as shown in the following figure, and here we are given 20 ohm resistance, okay, and 100 volt battery we are given. A point, B point and C, we are given 3 terminals, okay. He is asking, find potential difference across A and B. It means he is asking V, A, B, potential difference across A, B. We'll also find potential difference across B, C. V, B, C, potential difference across B, C. Okay. So he is asking find potential difference across AB and BC. This you have to find. First of all, you can see this question on this screen. You can take a screenshot. Either you can write this question. Okay. Now students, let's start. First of all, see students. We'll start with this circuit, this closed loop. When you flow the, look at, when you flow the charge, when you flow the current, okay, when you flow the charge, it divides in two parts here. Q1 and Q2. Suppose when you flow the charge, divide two parts, Q1 and Q2. Okay. So, charge again divided into two parts, Q3 and Q4. Basically, these two capacitors having different charge. Okay. So, these two will be in parallel combination. So, 3 microfarad and 3 microfarad. These two are having different charge, so they are in parallel combination. Okay. And we know what is total capacitance in parallel combination? C1 plus C2. 3 plus 3 become 6 microfarad. Look at students, before starting, I will tell you, we are also given in this question that the circuit are in steady state. The circuit are in steady state, it means all the capacitors are charged. There will be no current will flow, okay. Current will not flow in this circuit, so all the capacitor remains charged, current will not flow, charge will not flow in that condition. This resistance will be negated. Okay, there will be no use because there is no flow of charge because circuit is in steady state. Steady state means all the capacitors are charged, fully charged. Okay. Now students, 3 and 3 are in parallel, so it becomes 6. Now again, same life, this 1 microfarad and charge again divided into two parts, Q1 and Q2. So both have a different charge, same charge means series and different charge means parallel. Same like this, if 1 microfarad and 1 microfarad will be in a parallel combination. So, we know what is the formula of parallel combination in capacitance C1 plus C2, then write C3 plus C4, okay. So, 1 plus 1 that become 2 microfarad. Now, students, so 3 and 3 that become 6, 1 and 1 that become 2. This is 1 microfarad, 100 volt battery and 20 ohm resistance. Now, students, see. We'll find potential difference across AB and BC. But it should be clear that all are held parallel. So the potential difference across AC should equal to potential difference across PQ. This is suppose Q and this is suppose P. It means at 1 microfarad. Okay. So parallel, they are held parallel. Okay. When two or more wire are parallel, potential will be same. So, this is AC wire having 100 volt battery. So, potential difference across AC is 100. So, potential difference across 1 microfarad should also same, 100 volt. So, what we have done? Potential difference across AC will equal to potential difference across 1 microfarad. And that is also 100 volt. Okay. But now, students, we have to find actual potential difference between AB and BC. So now students look, for finding between A and B and B and C, we have to take capacitor. This 6 microfarad, 2 microfarad having same charge. So both capacitors should be in series combination. And we know in series combination, charge will divide in the ratio like V1 and V2. So charge will divide in the ratio of their capacitance. Okay. But one thing is there, as Q equals to CV, okay, and when we subjected V, it become Q by C. See students, potential is inversely proportional to capacitance. Potential is inversely proportional to capacitance. So 6 microfarad and 2 microfarad are in series. So potential will divide inverse ratio. The capacitor are in the ratio C1 to C2, that is 6:2. So the what is the ratio of potential of their capacitor? 2:6 inverse, because potential is inverse proportional to capacitance. So capacitor is 6:2, so potential will be 2:6, it means 1:3. Okay, now students, I'm going to remove this part. Okay, you can write this, you can take a screenshot. So look at students, so potential difference across A, B, 1 and 3, total ratio, sum of total ratio, okay, and then 1 is the, 1 is the ratio of cap potential between A and B, and what is total potential? 100. So it will come as 25 volt. So that will be the potential difference across AB, across 6 microfarad capacitor. Okay, this is a potential of only 6 microfarad. This is total potential, this is sum of ratio 1 plus 3, 4, and total potential is what? 100. So 100 will divide in two parts, 6 and 2, in the ratio of 1:3. Now students, potential difference across BC wire, its potential ratio is 3, total 4, and total potential 100. Okay, so it will come as 75 volt. So students, potential difference across AB will be 25 volt, and potential difference across BC will be 75 volt on account of this ratio. Okay, students, question number second. We are given 1 microfarad, 2 microfarad, 1 microfarad, 2 microfarad till infinity. The circuit leads to infinity. Okay, so what will do, students? That is a tricky question. In that type of question, what will do? What is the repeating path? 1 microfarad, 2 microfarad, 1, 2, 1, 2. So if we not consider the first one, still it's total capacitance will remain C, because circuit leads to infinity. Suppose we'll not consider two grids, still its total resistance will remain C. Okay, because circuit leads to infinity. If we'll not count first circuit where it take total resistance, it will remain C, because circuit is lead to infinity. So what will do, students? In that type of question, we will left the repeating circuit, like it's a 1, 2. This will remain as it is, and rest will assume as C, that is total resistance of this rest circuit. So again, we'll make the circuit, students. This is 2 microfarad, and this is 1 microfarad, and this will assume as C. Okay, now that was a infinite circuit. Now it converted into finite circuit. Now we can solve the circuit from closed side. This is first and this is second. When you flow the charge, it divides into parts, Q1 and Q2. So that is Q1. Q1 will flow in these two. It means 2 microfarad and C are in series, having same charge. 2 microfarad and that C are in series, because both having same charge. Same charge means series. And we know what is total formula in series combination? 1 upon C1 plus 1 upon C2. Okay. And we can, in short, we can write C1 C2 upon C1 plus C2. Okay. C2 we are having 2, and C1 we are having as C. So 2 into C. Okay. Suppose this is C dash. Okay. And C plus 2. C1 and C2. Okay. Now since this become 2C upon C plus 2, and this 2C will be parallel with this 1 microfarad. Why? Because this 2 having the charge Q1 and this one microwatt having the charge Q2. These two having same charge, says, but both 2 microfarad and C having different charge with as compared to 1. So the combination of this will be parallel with 1 microfarad. Understood? So this will be the parallel with 1 microfarad due to different charge. So 2C, C plus 2 and 1 microfarad are parallel. And you know what is the formula of parallel combination for equivalent capacitance? C equals to C1 plus C2. What is C1? 2C, C plus 2. And as C2, we are having 1 microfarad. Now students, we'll take LCM and try to solve this. Okay, so I'm going to remove this part. I think this is done. Now students, look at it. Take the LCM. The LCM will come, suppose LCM will come as C plus 2. Cancel out, that is 2C plus C plus 2. Now cross multiply, C into C, C square. 2 into C, 2C. 2C and C, that become 3C and that 2. C square, transfer 3C at that side, minus 3C plus 2C, minus C. Transfer 2 at that side, minus 2, 0. We can take, I think, factor. So make the factor. What we required, minus 2c square, minus 2c square, so minus c, minus 2c plus c, I think it will be sufficient. Look at minus 2c plus c, so minus c, and when we multiply we get, okay, minus 2c square. So now take the common, c minus 2 and c minus 2, okay, c minus 2 common, c plus 1 equals to 0. Okay students, now what we are, look students, C minus 2 equals 0, that gave 2 microfarad. And if we take this factor, C plus 1 equals 0, C equals to minus 1 microfarad. So capacitance will not take even negative sign, so we'll take capacitance with positive sign. So this will be the proper answer. So what should be the total capacitance on this circuit, equivalent capacitance on this circuit, that will be 2 microfarad. So now students, question number third, we are given 6 volt battery and 12 volt battery and resistance 1 ohm, 2 ohm and a capacitor having 5 microfarad capacitance. He is asking, find the potential difference across 5 microfarad capacitor as well as its charge. Okay, you can see the question on that screen. Okay, you can take a screenshot. Now we have to find its potential difference as well as its charge. Okay. Look students, first of all we'll find total current. Circuit are given in a steady state. Okay, total current will be, okay, total net EMF upon total resistance. What is the net EMF? Suppose when you flow the charge, okay, when you flow the current I will flow, okay, at that junction current will not divide. Why? Because there is a capacitor. So same current will flow in upside, because we've discussed before that capacitor does not accept DC current. Capacitor only accept the AC current, okay, alternating current. Battery will provide direct current, so it will not accept. The current will flow from upside, okay. It means 2 ohm and 1 ohm having same current I. So these two are in series. So net EMF by total resistance. What is net EMF? Look students, this is not considered because current is not flowing. So we are having two cells, okay. Plus connected with plus. So it will, like poles are connected of the terminal. So it will oppose. So net EMF will be what? 12 minus 6. Okay. And what is total resistance? 2 ohm and 1 ohm having same current. And same current will be in series. It means 2 and 1 are in series. So 1 plus 2. R1, I applied R1 plus R2. So it will come as 6 by 3 means 2 ampere. So how much current will flow by this? That is 2 ampere in that circuit. The circuit are in steady state. Okay. Now students, all are held parallel. And we know in parallel combination, potential remains same. So potential difference across AF will equals to potential difference across BE, isn't it? Because we are taking these two wires because we have to find the potential of charge of this capacitor. Both are parallel and parallel combination potential should be equal. Now potential difference of between A and F, how can you find? We are having cell and resistance. So this is 6 volt minus. How can we find the resistance of this? How can we find the potential of this 1 ohm? V equals to IR by this formula. V equals to IR. Roughly I am just writing. Current, what? Current is what? Current is what? 2 ampere. Current is 2 ampere and resistance 1. So 1 into 2. Same like in for finding potential difference between B and D. We are having two segments. 6 volt battery. 6 minus. We require its potential as well as charge. So that is unknown. We'll write VC. Potential at capacitor. So 2, 6 minus 2, 4, 6 minus VC. So VC come as 6 minus 4, 2 volt. So what should be the potential at 5 microfarad capacitor? That is 2 volt. Understood, students? Now one more thing, we have to find charge also. By the formula, Q equals to CV. See, 5 microfarad, 5, okay, we'll write 5 microfarad. We can also convert microfarad into farad by multiplying 10 to the power minus 6. And V is 2. 10 microcoulomb. So what was the potential? 2 volt. And what will you charge? 10 microcoulomb. And if you want to remove this micro, you can write 10 into 10 to the power minus 6 coulomb. So microcoulomb will convert into coulomb. So this is the charge of this 5 microfarad. Understood, students?